Team Eastbound!
Welcome to the 12th annual Fish for a Cure tournament. 80 boats in the water, the wind was biting, but the fish didn't always follow.
It doesn't matter how uncomfortable it is out there, it's not what they go through.
They are cancer patients. The fishing coolers will help them swim past what insurance covers.
We had a good time. It wasn't about winning or losing. Raise the money and have fun.
A long and wet day on the water ends on the docks at the Annapolis Waterfront Hotel.
4 to 5 feet all day. Waves. Lots of wind.
Wes Sims shared this video of the rough ride. His life's work is spent raising money for cancer patients.
You don't know how to answer questions, like about your diagnosis, about your treatment program, about how you're going to fight through it, what you're going to deal with, how to even process your insurance. So what patient navigators do is they basically intervene on your behalf.
Among the red faces returning to the docks, Dr. Stanley Watkins, a retired oncologist at Anne Arundel Medical Center and a survivor of prostate cancer.
It always pays to be on the other side of the desk or the other side of the bed, and so you can figure out what's going on. And it gives you some idea of sort of what the patient's going through.
Money raised at the tournament supports the patient navigator program at the hospital.
The number of sort of missed appointments, wrong medicines, incorrect diagnoses, that kind of thing has been helped immensely by having sort of having a person that looks after you.
Chesapeake Bay Magazine sponsored a boat with Eastport Yacht Club during what's known as Rocktober.
It's the colder water. The fish start to move out of their little hiding places for the summer. And they sneak into the middle of the bay and they get real hungry because it's cold.
We ended up catching 4 fish on light tackle.
That's a nice fish.
It's time to show off the catch. The weigh-in is always a party.
9.85.
Rockfish are hung up and the biggest one belongs to Brian Heller at more than 17 pounds.
We take the fundraising more seriously than the fishing.
Brian and his team won the Rockfish tournament. They came in second for fundraising with more than $60,000. Team Real Hunter donated close to $64,000 and took the top spot. These are the highest numbers the tournament has ever seen, with a total topping $500,000 for this day of fishing.
The most memorable lines dropped come from cancer patients right here at Anne Arundel Medical Center.
I have been wearing a Fish for a Cure shirt and had somebody say, I think that what you do pays for part of my salary.
Is that legal?
You often hear of the fish that got away. Well, on this day, fish tales tell a story that may one day lead to a cure. For Chesapeake Bay Magazine's Bay Bulletin, I'm Cheryl Costello.